Chapter 1. 10 years later. Elena woke up very tired and stressed out. The morning sun shone through the window. It was a beautiful morning like always. Being a grown-up was definitely a hard thing to do. Elena was told to be a lady rather than a knight or a jouster. She didn't know how to be a lady. If it had to involve romance, then she wasn't succeeding. Elena didn't have a lover or even a first kiss ever in her life. She wanted marriage, but not an arranged marriage involving a husband who killed his wives or a husband that was much older than her and rough with her. "Elena, are you up yet?" called Elena's mother. "Yes, mother, I am up. I'll be down in a few minutes," Elena called back. Elena called for her maid Beatrix to help her get dressed and her hair done. She put her golden blonde hair in a loose French braid and got changed into a red gown. Elena went downstairs to see her father, King James, who she had a bad relationship with, her mother, Queen Natalie, a few guards and servants delivering food and wine. "Her Highness, Princess Elena of Scotland," called one of the guards at the door. Everyone who was sitting down bowed down at Elena and saying, "Your Highness," as she elegantly walked past them. She walked up to her parents and sat in the seat between the two thrones that were at the table. Elena tried to smile as she sat down, but she was really not in a happy mood. The food that was served to her was a boar pie and some eel stew, her favourite. Elena was served a goblet of sweet wine by one of the servants who was called Isabel. "Elena, you have been arranged to marry Connor Murphy, who is a knight. He is 34 years of age. He is said to be a good husband, but his last wife died in the past 4 years, reasons unknown," announced King James. Elena gave a face of shock and surprise. She wasn't right for marriage. She wanted to find the right man for her that wasn't arranged by her father. "Father, are you sure about this?" said Elena, turned her face to James, her voice trembling. "Yes, I am pretty sure about this," shouted James. There was complete silence in the entire room, except for whispering from the guests across from them. "I shall have permission to return to my bedchamber," responded Elena. Her mother Natalie nodded at Elena, and she got up and walked upstairs to her bedchamber. Elena flung herself onto her bed and buried her face in one of the pillows, sobbing uncontrollably. A knock on the door got her to stop crying. "Come in," sobbed Elena. Her best friend Bella van der Hade, yes, that's how you say Bella van der Hade, it's not Bella van der Gaard. I hate when people say that. Look, because it's Dutch. Well, Bella van der Hade walked in, wearing a yellow gown and her brown hair held with hairpins. Bella was 18 years old, like Elena, heralded from the Netherlands, and was very supportive of Elena no matter what decision she made. Bella wasn't married, but she had a lover, William Braveheart. "I do not know why I chose the name Braveheart. I was stuck on names. But at the time, I didn't even watch the movie Braveheart." William Braveheart, who she first met at a ball. Oh, was he called William as well? Shoot. Now, Bella and Elena have been best friends for as long as they could remember when they first met at the village in Edinburgh. "Elena, what's the matter? What happened earlier?" now asked Bella with concern. "I don't know. My father doesn't like me for some reason," replied Elena with her voice trembling. "Well, I have some information on Connor Murphy, because you shouldn't marry him for your own good," explained Bella. Elena nodded at Bella in agreement. "Connor Murphy's last wives were killed by him because they wouldn't obey him on anything he wanted them to do, so he threw them over a wall at his castle and they fell to their deaths. I know this because I witnessed it once when I was on a vacation in Northumbria," explained Bella with a worried voice. Elena was in shock. That man killed his wives just for disobeying him? He was so much older than her, which she didn't want. "Why would he do such a thing?" asked Elena. "Nobody knows. However, I have to get going now. My mother and father must be wondering why I'm taking very long. See you another time," said Bella before she walked out the door. Elena sat on her bed for a moment, then got up to stroll down to the private dining room downstairs. "James, I don't think Elena should marry this man. Everyone, even Bella van der Hade and the guards, have been saying that Connor Murphy threw his last wives to their deaths," explained Natalie. James gave a frustrated sigh, got out of his seat, and stared at Natalie really hard. "Natalie, we need to make sure Elena saves her reputation when she marries Connor Murphy, and not Daniel Defoilet, who is the son of her enemies," said James calmly. "Father, if I marry Defoilet, it could bring peace to our families," argued Elena. "No daughter of mine is going to marry a family enemy," shouted James at Elena. Natalie sighed in frustration and crossed arms across her chest. "Father, why do you hate me so?" demanded Elena. "Young lady, go to your room now," shouted James. Elena sighed in anger and stomped out of the room and slammed the door, which got paint to fall out of the wall. "James, why do you hate our daughter? Was it because of her playing with Daniel Defoilet 10 years ago?" asked Natalie in concern. "No, Natalie, it isn't that. I hated her from the day she was born," responded James roughly. And that's the end of chapter 1. I think there's 14 more chapters to go. I can't remember. I think I did 15 chapters and then there's an epilogue, but I don't know. See you guys next time.